Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. We humbly ask you, Lord, lover of all our human family, to pour out more fully upon us the grace of your Spirit, and grant that walking worthily in the vocation to which you have called us, we may be a witness to the truth before others, and seek with confidence the unity of all believers in the bond of peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. A tabernacle was constructed, the outer one, in which were the lampstand, the table, and the bread of offering. This is called the holy place. Behind the second veil was the tabernacle called the Holy of Holies. But when Christ came as high priest of the good things that have come to be, passing through the greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made by hands, that is, not belonging to this creation, he entered once for all into the sanctuary, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the sprinkling of a heifer's ashes can sanctify those who are defiled, so that their flesh is cleansed, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God, cleanse our consciences from the dead works to worship the living God? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God mounts his throne with shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
All you peoples, clap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness, for the Lord the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God mounts his throne amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid trumpet blasts. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
For King of all the earth is God, sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations, God sits upon his holy throne.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Open our hearts, O Lord, to listen to the words of your Son. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus came with his disciples into the house. Again, the crowd gathered, making it impossible for them even to eat. When his relatives heard of this, they set out to seize him, for they said, he is out of his mind. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In Dear friends, today's gospel is a very concise, short, brief, disappointing, and perhaps even sad gospel. Jesus has been engaged in his public ministry, his ministry of preaching, healing, showing compassion, love, and care to all those around him, healing illnesses, driving out demons from those who were possessed. And what he is meeting now is opposition and even disbelief, and especially from those closest to him. Indeed, what we see in today's gospel is that his family, they have come, as they say, to seize him, for they said he's out of his mind. Now, to be out of his mind is to refer to his mental state. He's mentally ill, is what they're saying. And in Jesus' day, mental illness was severely stigmatized. To be mentally ill, as it were, was to be somehow possessed by some evil demon and spirit. And as this narrative in the gospel continues, you will hear that that's exactly what they'll say. He casts out demons, he heals, because he himself is possessed by a demon. Now, unfortunately, even in our day, mental health is still stigmatized. What we fail to grasp, unfortunately, is that we human beings are both physical and mental realities. There are physical and mental dimensions to who we are. And just as we can be physically ill, and our physical illness can be properly treated by those who are trained professionals precisely for that purpose, we can be mentally ill as well. And our mental illness, likewise, can be treated by those professionally trained precisely for that purpose. And so, just as we treat physical illness with compassion and care, we should also treat mental illness, likewise, with the same compassion and care. We all should do that. We all should make sure that those who are mentally ill are properly treated, cared for by those qualified to do so. That's critically important. Being compassionate, caring for those who are mentally ill, that's the intelligent and understanding way in which to look at mental illness. Now, as this narrative continues, Jesus will be told, your family, they're here, they've come to get you, take you away. And he responds that my family are those who hear the word of God and keep it. In other words, opening our hearts and minds and our wills to understanding, hearing, and following the word and will of God. That's fundamental. It's as fundamental as our family relationships, or perhaps even more so. It's a very interesting gospel today. It's sad, it's disappointing, but it's very instructive. Among us, of course, just as there are many who do suffer from physical illnesses, there are those who suffer from mental illnesses as well. And our task, of course, is to be supportive of them, to be encouraging of them, to be understanding and compassionate towards them, and if need be, to see to it that they get the proper care that they need to assist them in their illness. Just as physical illness is a reality of our fallen and imperfect nature, so too are mental illnesses. And I think we need to be fully cognizant of that. We need to understand that. And we need to be compassionate in our understanding and in our actions toward those who are mentally ill. Today, of course, is our sixth day within the week of prayer for Christian unity. And I will share with you now the meditation for this day, prepared jointly by the World Council of Churches and the Pontifical Council for Promoting Christian Unity from the Roman Catholic Church. It reads as follows. Then we let ourselves be transformed by Christ. His love in us grows and bears fruit. Welcoming the other is a concrete way of sharing the love that is within us. Throughout his life, Jesus welcomed those he met. He listened to them and let himself touched by them without being afraid of their suffering. In the gospel account of the multiplication of the loaves, Jesus is moved with compassion after seeing the hungry crowd. He knows that the entire human person must be nourished, and that he alone can truly satisfy the hunger for bread and the thirst for life. But he does not wish to do this without his disciples, without that little something that they can give him, 5 loaves and 2 fish. Even today he draws us to be co-workers in his unconditional care. Sometimes something as small as a kind look, an open ear, or our presence is enough to make a person feel welcome. When we offer our poor abilities to Jesus, he uses them in a surprising way. We then experience what Abraham did, for it was by giving that we receive, and when we welcome others, we are blessed in abundance. The prayer for the 6th day. Jesus Christ, we desire to welcome fully the brothers and sisters who are with us. You know how often we feel helpless in the face of their suffering, yet you are always there ahead of us, and you have already received them in your compassion. Speak to them through our words, support them through our actions, and let your blessings rest. Let us pray. We put our needs before the Lord this day as we offer these prayers and petitions. We pray for the church throughout the world, that in all its various dimensions it may seek deeper and deeper unity between churches and ecclesial communities. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for Francis, our Pope, that he may continue to lead us after the manner of Christ the Good Shepherd, with courage and compassion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this day we especially may those who are ill with mental illness of whatever sort, that the Lord grant them comfort, and the Lord teach us all to be compassionate towards those who are mentally ill. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray that the Lord may continue to put joy in our hearts even in this time of pandemic. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we ask you now to put before the Lord whatever needs you find most burdensome this day. Gracious Lord, we pour out our hearts to you in prayer, and we ask that you hear and grant our needs in accord with your will. You lived this existence which we now live, so you know what challenges, what need, what pains we can experience. Hear our prayers, grant our needs, touch us with your word and your presence, and bless us always. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, who gave for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through him you brought us to the knowledge of your truth, so that by the bond of one faith and one baptism, Spirit among all the nations, so that in a wondrous manner he might prompt and engender unity in the diversity of your gifts, dwelling within your adopted children, and filling and ruling the whole church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You therefore, Almighty Father, be blessed through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves have turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that, converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, who for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating that reconciliation Christ has brought for us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when he was about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Celebrating therefore the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all peoples, and may he keep us in communion with Francis our Pope, with thee your unworthy servant, with all the bishops, and with your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and with all the saints, with our brothers and sisters of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share in the understanding, unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Now, as our customs in these times, we make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are really present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I hunger to receive you. Since I cannot receive communion at this moment, feed my soul at least spiritually. I unite myself wholly to you now, as I do when I actually receive you. Permit me never to be separated from you. Let us pray. At this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, it foreshadows the union of the faithful in you. So may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Dear friends, once again, thank you for joining me today, virtually, for the celebration of the Mass. Our Mass, our streamed Mass for this tomorrow, Sunday the 3rd, Sunday of Ordinary Time, will come from St. Bede Parish with Father William Kwanju and the wonderful little community of St. Bede's Parish. So have a wonderful day. Remember, we're still in a pandemic. We must be sincere, disciplined, committed, and consistent in practicing our safety protocols. That is, wearing our face masks in public, social distancing in crowds, and of course, frequent hand washing and hand sanitizing. Let us continue to practice those disciplines for our personal health.